Like many of you, my holiday was filled with family, friends, and lots of eating, which is why this month I'm trying to get back to a healthier lifestyle. Sure, part of that is trying to maintain my supermodel physique, but it's also to protect myself against developing problems like diabetes, which affects 29 million Americans. There are two main types of diabetes. In type 1, the body doesn't make enough insulin and is therefore unable to utilize glucose. In type 2, which is more commonly diagnosed later in life, your body may produce insulin, but it is unable to use it properly. But what are the warning signs for diabetes, and how can diet play a role in its treatment? I'm going to grab some lunch, and then I'm going to talk to Jerry Spollett, Associate Director of the Yale Diabetes Center, inside the exam room.
Well, the warning signs are the same for type 1 and for type 2. Basically, we start out with people feeling the need to urinate more often. And that's because the body's trying to get rid of that extra glucose from the bloodstream. That then causes people to be thirsty. They become hungry or they start to lose weight. Because type 2 takes a little longer to develop in people, oftentimes their symptoms are not as profound. So they may talk about being really tired. They may have more frequent skin infections. They may find that they get up to urinate during the night more often, but they seem to be okay during the day. Most people think about sugar as being the thing that they need to avoid, and that's not true. Almost every food that you eat breaks down into a form of sugar over time. And so really it's about eating a balanced menu. We know that if you can lose between 5 and 10% of your current body weight, that you can reduce your chances of developing diabetes. The best thing you can do to prevent your diabetes, 150 minutes a week of exercise, try to avoid processed foods, eat whole grains, fruits, vegetables, weigh yourself, make sure that you're as close to an ideal body weight that you can be, reduce their stress levels if they can. The other thing that often goes unnoticed is smoking. Diabetes can underlie cardiovascular disease, and smoking makes those arteries even narrower. In dealing with diabetes for over 30 years, what I've noticed is that people are very afraid of diabetes. They think of it as a disease that's going to cause them to go blind, that they're going to lose their limbs to diabetes. And I think the message I'd like to give people is that while it's a disease that we have to pay attention to and manage, we actually know more about diabetes than we've ever known before. We have better treatments than we've ever had before. And diabetes, as your mother might have known it, is not the diabetes that we have today.
If you're worried you might have diabetes, the first thing to do is go to your doctor for a simple blood test. The earlier you get a diagnosis of diabetes, or even pre-diabetes, the easier it is to treat with medication and a change of lifestyle. Hope you're having a sweet start to 2016, and I'll see you next month inside the exam room.